Next, we have Rakshita Didi, who is going to talk about the geographical importance of Uttarakhand. Over to you, Rakshita.
Hari Om. Myself, Rakshita, I'll be telling you all about the geographic importance of Uttarakhand. The land of gods. Do you all know why is it called the land of gods? Okay. What is the other name of Uttarakhand? Any guesses?
Uttarakhand.
Devi Bhumi.
Yeah, land of gods is called Dev Bhumi, but the other name of Uttarakhand itself?
Uttaranchal.
Uttaranchal. Yes. Uttarakhand is also known as Uttaranchal. It is in the northern part of India. Why is it called Devabhumi? It's because of the holy places and the pilgrimage centers present in this place throughout. The meaning of Uttarakhand itself. Uttara is the north and Khand is a part. So it's in the northern part, so it's known as Uttarakhand. It is known by the natural beauty of the Babar and the Terai regions of the Himalayas. And it's also the 20th most populous state of India. Unlike other states, Uttarakhand has two capitals. Can you guess?
Dehradun.
Yes. Dehradun. Which is the other one? Okay. It has two capitals. One is the summer capital and the other one is the winter capital. Summer capital is Gharsi and the winter capital is Dehradun. And there are totally 13 districts, which is divided into Garhwal region and Gharsin region. And the High Court, Nainital is the High Court, which serves all the districts. And it has a borders, Tibet in the north, Nepal to the east, Uttar Pradesh to the south, and Himachal Pradesh towards the west. And coming to the climate, January is the coldest month and the May is the warmest month. June, the hottest. And July to September, it receives the annual rainfall by the southwest monsoon. And December, it is the coldest. This area is always prone to floods, landslides during monsoon because of the... Because? Any idea?
Lower stretches of the valley.
It's not in a flat land. It's not a flat land, right? It is in a higher altitude. That is where the difference has come. And why is there an extreme changes in the northern part of Uttarakhand and the southern part of Uttarakhand? Any idea? Because the northern is covered only with the glaciers of Himalayas and it's mostly cold. And the southern is covered by the tropical forests. Yes, it is because of the highest elevation of the subtropical forest and the lower elevation of the glaciers. Yes. And now the yummy cuisines of Uttarakhand. Panu, Tatwani, Dubar, Sisnuka Saag, Kafuli, Chainsu. Yummy, right? All of us want to go here and taste. Yes.
Yes.
And that sweet delicacies. Bal Mitai, Gulgula, Jhanjorka Keer, and Singhori. Yes. Do you know the official language of Uttarakhand? We all have an official language, right? In every state. What is it in Uttarakhand? Any guesses?
Hindi?
Yes.
Hindi.
Yes. Official language of Uttarakhand is Hindi. And also
Hindi.
Sanskrit is the second official language which is declared by the government. Other languages
English.
Spoken? Yeah, English and Hindi are taught in the institutional centers. Other languages are Garhwali, Pahari, Punjabi, Bhojpuri, etc. Yes. And now lastly, coming to the emblem. Like every other state has its emblem, Uttar Pradesh too has, Uttarakhand has it too. The emblem of Uttarakhand is a diamond-shaped emblem with a white background and blue borders supporting the stylish mountain peaks of the Himalayas. Also, the lion capital of Ashoka is superimposed on the emblem. And it also has a motto, national motto, Satyameva Jayate. At the borders, with a blue color, it is inscribed Uttarakhand Raj. Here, the red diamond is imposed, right? That indicates the blood of the statehood activists who fought for the separation of Uttarakhand Raj. And then this is the lion capital, Ashoka symbol. And the white is the peaceful nature of the people in Uttarakhand. And the stylish wavy lines is the river Ganga. And the mountains here are the mountain peaks of Himalayas. And the blue is the purity of the water in the Uttarakhand Raj. Thank you, Hari Om. Hope you all enjoyed.
Thank you, Rakshita. Most of all, the significance of emblem was too good. You see how our Indian emblems, each and everything, each and every part has got an importance. Thank you, Rakshita, for the effort taken.